What's up, everybody?
What's going on? How was your Thanksgiving, man?
Man, my Thanksgiving was great, dude.
Right.
Well, obviously, you know how it was. You were with me.
Right. Well, dinner at the Ross.
Yeah, we had Thanksgiving at the Ross Steaks.
Yeah.
Yeah. We all had a ham sandwich and beanie weenies. No. Yeah, good stuff. Mom had about 8 or 9 pies.
Oh,
hope everybody out there had a good Thanksgiving.
No doubt.
And hopefully, 500 years from now, when they see this in the metaverse, you'll still be celebrating Thanksgiving, or you're going to be eating digital turkey. You'll be sitting at home, you only weigh 80 pounds, but you're on a diet because your metaverse weighs like 300 pounds. So, didn't realize Pete Townsend had a solo album.
Yeah, that's a blast. Very good. Back in 80.
I knew it had to be around 80.
Yeah. Very good,
A little intriguing with the what is it, 14th, 15th century Renaissance halo around him. Instead of oil on canvas, CD on CD.
Yeah, man.
Never heard of these songs. This one's called Rough Boys. Yeah. Okay, I saw them last night on PBS. They were special. If I'm not mistaken, if I didn't read this in the Record Guide Bible, but I read it somewhere else, did it not say that at one time the Who were trying to be like Zeppelin? No, it wasn't in there. I read an article one time. It was from Rolling Stone. It talked about how that this guy that was reviewing the Who. He always felt that they were kind of trying to keep up with like Zeppelin.
Right.
They were trying to be like Zeppelin. And that's not really true. Because this guy here, he was your innovative guy. He was the one that was working on your early keyboard music, which is the size of a wall, with vacuum tubes and whatever. And that's how you made your guitar, like you'd run it through an amp and it would make it sound weird. That's how he came up with these looped riffs. And like Baba O'Reilly and all kinds of stuff with the Who. But I always felt that there was like a power struggle between, oh my God.
Page.
No. Between Pete Townsend and the lead singer from the Who.
Roger Daltrey.
I always felt like there was kind of a power struggle. But once again, the same person that drove the Who is the same person that drove Led Zeppelin, the lead guitarist. Pete Townsend drove the Who. Jimmy Page drove Zeppelin. You had great voices in Page and Plant. I mean, Daltrey and Robert Plant. But there again, the lead guitarist, it seemed like they just drove the direction of the band and the music they were going for some reason. I mean, but when you have somebody who is so good as this, that's as good as Pete Townsend, you know, I mean, go with it, man. I mean, Carmen doesn't quite get the concept. Of course, neither does Cody, for that matter. Some other younger people with pinball vision, you know what I'm saying? They don't quite understand it. They don't know. Of course, Tommy, they don't get Tommy. Right, they don't get it, you know, so. But you were coming off the cusp of people like Freddie Mercury, who was making these long opera slash rock albums, literally with the Italian fat lady, the rock, opera singer from his 70s. She was really big, really popular. She was like the, what was her name? I'm trying to think of her name.
Yeah.
Can't remember her name anyway, but.
Right. But still.
But yeah, I mean, but they were experimenting. I mean, you had, you know, just different, I mean, well, if you think about it, Elton John was doing the same type of thing.
Sure.
When he was doing like Captain Fantastic and this different stuff, they had these breakdowns of albums, you know. I mean, for that matter, just lost the drum. Rush was the same way.
Right.
Even though it's a rock album, it was almost like concertos.
Right.
Like it was brought out into these segments of a symphony.
Right.
I mean, you had Neil Peart, he never could have been a 2-3 or another beat type of drummer. He had to go from fast to soft to just whatever. Like they had these concertos, basically. It's the only way you can describe it. It's like a rock opera, you know.
Yeah.
And I feel like he took that on here. For somebody who's never heard this album, we talk a lot, but I'm a Who fan. Of course, I'm a Pete Townsend fan. I loved how he had enough gumption and innovative spirit to where he worked, they said, for hours on the wall at the studio where they, like I said, had the wires and the tubes that would make the, what they call in early days, the synthesizers, where it would make the synthesizing sound. Nowadays, we think of a synthesizer, that's just another thing on your piano. Back then, it wasn't. It's where you ran this synthesizer with these tubes and vacuums and cables that was the size of the wall right here, and you'd move them around, it would make a different noise. Well, he would work it so much to where, because there was an infinite amount of ways to move it, to where he found a sound he liked. And back then, that's how you created those sounds, you know? I mean, it's kind of like Dylan when he come out to the folk festival and he's got an electrified guitar. Oh, you know, boy, people are like, whoa, what are you doing? Down. Are you out of your fucking mind?
So loud.
No, that loud, rackety mess, what are you doing, you know? You better slow your roll, buddy.
Yeah.
You know, you know what? There was a producer back then who said, you know what? This Dylan guy with his stuff, he's not going to make it very long in this industry. Right. You know, they told Willie Nelson the same thing. He's wrote... what, hundreds of songs, like songs that Elvis Presley songs, whatever, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people were dejected, which I feel like that the grandfathers of, call me wrong if you want, Steve, I need your input on this. You know, in the 80s with your new wave and your different type of music, I feel like they were influenced by these rock operas. Obviously, because they would listen to it. They were different. They went outside of the norm. You know, you just got to break outside the box. You can have people doing rock operas, you know. Yeah. Everybody sound the same. Yeah. And you have a cookie-cutter type rock band, basically. And then when you have these ones that are, like, outside of the box, back then they were called icons and rock legends. Now they're like new wave. Like, 106.5 is known as... No, I'm not that. I know the end, but the
alternative?
Genre. Alternative, you know what I'm saying? I mean, yeah, Talking Heads. Yeah. They're alternative, you know.
They're more new wave.
But see, there's where me and you always have a hiccup. I feel like new wave is the old. Let me put it back. I feel like new wave, the definition of new wave to me is the original alternative music. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
I feel like new wave was the springboard of alternative. Right. I call alternative the new version of new wave.
Right.
So there you go.
I
feel like they both are the same.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because if you didn't have Talking Heads or you didn't have Pete Townsend doing his thing on his own, experimenting with this type of music, you wouldn't have had Beck. You know what I'm saying? Even Run DMC, or not Beastie Boys, for that matter.
Right.
You wouldn't have those type of groups. So.
Which Beck? Beck or Jeff Beck?
New Wave Beck, because Jeff Beck wasn't New Wave. So, but you know, I like it. I like this movie. This might be a CD guys or an album that you guys play that you might not like one or two songs on it, but you're gonna like a couple songs on it. I guarantee you. You know what I'm saying? So.
Listen to it.
Yeah. Because it's his voice feel and it's his music, so.
It's Pete Townsend.
It's Pete Townsend, exactly right. You know what I'm saying? You can't go that much wrong with it, you know?
Okay.
It'd be like Jimmy Page trying to come up with something, like, no, I don't know if I really like that because I've never heard it, you know?
Right.
You don't like that part of the riff, just listen to the song and be something that you like,
right.
I promise. But, I mean, I will say this, he's in the genre of the groups to where they've made an album to where every song on the album I enjoy.
Right.
There's only a few groups out there or artists who you can honestly say, hey, I can put in their album, and no matter what song's playing, I enjoy it.
Yeah.
That's a rarity, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And I do that with Elton John.
Yeah.
I can throw him anything, even his newer stuff. Throw it in, I enjoy it, you know what I'm saying? There's not much I don't like.
Yeah.
There's a few things I may, like Nikita, some stuff I didn't like with ZZ Top. You might have your old rocker from Texas who's an old, you know, an old hippie. He's like, I love ZZ Top. Well, I guarantee you, when they got out with She's Got Legs, you probably fell off the wagon. But it's still ZZ Top on the list.
Yeah,
exactly. I always put ZZ Top and Aerosmith in the same category. You go from Nationwide to Back in the Saddle, those versions, Two, she's got legs, or dude looks like a lady.
Right.
Either way, they were both monetary success. In fact, the newer shitty stuff was even more successful. Because you had MTV videos.
Well, yeah, that's what made it.
That's what made it. MTV single-handedly revived, I wouldn't say revived, but kept alive. Yeah. Like, who's the one that says he's got the steamroller, whatever.
James Taylor?
That's steamroller, but...
Peter Gabriel.
Peter Gabriel.
Genesis?
Yep, Peter Gabriel. Peter Gabriel's whole solo career was actually bolstered by MTV because of his music videos. He had some of the coolest music videos.
Shot the monkey.
Yeah, exactly, dude. I mean, same with ZZ Top. You think that genre of kids would have gone with two old bearded guys from Texas who sang about stuff? No. It was those videos, man. They got them... It was all synthesized. Like Van Halen, single-handedly, whether it was with Sammy or with David, MTV made them. You had Jump. By the way, the original video of Jump shows him jumping backwards because they couldn't change it in the editing process.
Right.
So little money that he's doing a backwards jump and actually flipped the other way.
Right.
But then Sammy Hagar, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can't drive 55, the video.
Yeah.
We're taking a break, guys.
We'll be right back.